Hello, and welcome to this edition of Focus on Design with Hunter Industries. Now, irrigation is one of those peculiar landscape subjects that seems so simple, but gets complicated quickly. On one hand, irrigation equipment is abundant and access is easy. Just about anyone can purchase and install components. On the other hand, irrigation design at times can seem like rocket science when we start thinking about things like fluid dynamics and operating parameters and water supply versus water demand and friction loss and water windows and all those other things that we must take into consideration when designing. Well, Hunter has developed a companion tool for irrigation designers to navigate these variables in all phases of the design process. That's the Handbook of Technical Irrigation Information. And I'm Bryce Cornell, and joining us today is Mr. Don Franklin of Franklin Irrigation Consulting. And Don has over 51 years experience in the industry. And full disclosure, he spent 13 years as a sales representative with Hunter Industries. Don, thank you for joining us here today.
Thank you for allowing me to hang out with you.
Yes, indeed. Thanks. So, and Don, you've shared with me in the past that this handbook has helped you solve quite a bit of irrigation challenges throughout your career. Now, thinking about the different design phases of an irrigation design project, what are a few things this handbook can help out with when you're first getting started on a project?
Well, one of the first things that I want to know is what are my supply requirements? And so I'm going to want to take a look if I've got a certain amount of acreage and I have so much ET per month. I'm going to want to know just how many gallons I'm going to need for that given area. And this particular chart is great for that, as it's giving you ET in per month and per day and then gallons per day. It's a great quick reference to get you kind of on the target board, if you will, on how much water you're really going to need. The other thing that I'll look at is meter capacity. Based on this chart, now I want to know how big of a meter I'm going to need in order to irrigate that area. And so this chart is a great reference tool. All these gray areas in the chart are at plus 75%, and you never want to choose a meter and go over that 75% because your pressure losses are just too great on that. The other thing that I look at is that I'll want to know what my maximum system capacity is. And so for any particular hydro zone, what I will do for the worst case scenario, I want to know how many gallons that I'm going to need for that particular hydro zone. And the entire project can be one hydro zone, so you can quickly determine your GPM for an entire project, which will help you size your main line. In areas where I have maybe a finite source of water, like water harvesting or something along those lines, then based on the gallons that I have for that, how big of an area can I really irrigate? So I'll take a look at this calculation frequently. And in fact, what I've done is put them into an Excel spreadsheet so I can calculate that very quickly. And then during the design phases, I want to know how many sprinklers that I'm going to need for any given area. This chart is great for sprinklers spaced rectangular or square or equilateral triangles. I refer to this chart a lot. This will also help me not only determine how many sprinklers I need on the spacing, but also help me to figure out my costs even before I have done any irrigation design.
Yeah, that's great. Thank you, Don. Thanks for sharing that. So now, you know, we understand that figuring this stuff out during the start of the project will help us get a start in the right direction and to help us make good decisions later on in the design process. But what are a few things that you refer to in this handbook when you're actually designing?
Well, I'm going to want to know kind of the topography, if you will, of the project that I'm working with. And a lot of times I'll be working with other disciplines, and their language is going to be, they may use degree of slope and somebody might use a slope ratio. And so this chart just really helps me to kind of understand what they're talking about. The other thing that I like to look at is the maximum precipitation rate for any given slope. That is huge because you don't want to have a lot of runoff. And so this will help me to design, choose the product that will give me the lowest precip rate for that particular type of soil, or help match the precipitation rate to the intake rate. The other thing that I will take a look at, particularly if I'm pulling off of a pond or out of a well, is I want to know screen filter sizes. And again, talking with different disciplines, some will talk in mesh and some will talk in microns. And so this is a great chart to reference between the two.
Thanks, Don. So when I was designing now, I relied heavily on the friction loss reference charts through the design refinement stage. And what are some other things that you look for in this book during your design refinement?
Well, I will go to the friction loss charts. I heavily rely on the friction loss charts. That way I'm not having to do the Hayes-Williams conversion for everything. And so this part of the manual is great. It's an exhaustive list of different types of pipes and whatnot, and the friction losses that you have. And so I will refer to these charts frequently, particularly if I'm doing a really large project, say a synthetic sports field or something like that, and I need a really good type of pipe. So I'll typically kind of fall back on HDPE. And so the long and the short of it is, these friction loss charts have just about every type of pipe that you could that you can use in your system. The other thing that I'll do is a lot of times on these larger systems, I may need additional pressure. And so I'm not a pump guy, but I can kind of sort of figure out how much horsepower I'm going to need sort of based on either the feet of head or the pressure that I'm going to need based on the flow. So if I'm looking at a specific flow and I need a specific amount of pressure, then it'll tell me how many horsepower. It's a great reference chart. And then as we're going through and getting everything designed in, how am I going to schedule this? And so in this book, you have great references on how frequently you need to irrigate, how to calculate the station runtime, all of this. So these are great reference calculations. And again, I have put them into a spreadsheet to, make my work a little faster. A lot of times on these large systems, also, Bryce, is that you'll get into looped mainlines. And that seems to be a mystery for some folks. This particular chart helps to dispel all the mysteries if you're wanting to know kind of where your valves are in certain points of your loop mainline. This will tell you what your flow rates are and what your and how much pressure loss you may have in that. A lot of times, too, on two-wire systems and or trying to do some electrical troubleshooting with friends, is that this book has a great electrical section where you can calculate voltages and amperages and resistance and whatnot, based on some of the knowns that you may have. So it's a great, great reference tool, and it's not far from my side. I even have the PDF version in my phone.
Oh, that's great. So clearly this is a robust resource and solution to help you with your design work. So is there anything else you'd like to add?
Well, you know, it's not just on irrigation design. I mean, if you're doing lighting designs and stuff like that, this is a great reference tool for that. And it's you also have a great conversion table in here. So if you need to convert from imperial to metric or metric to imperial or, you know, whatever, these conversion tables are just priceless.
Yeah, thank you, Don. Thank you very much. It's clear, like I said, clearly a really great tool to have. And I want to thank everybody for joining us today. You know, we understand that the pressure involved in designing a functional irrigation system within a budgeted amount of time is can be a challenge. So we hope that this conversation has shed some light on how to find out some solutions to those tough irrigation challenges. You know, Hunter is here to help you develop accurate functional irrigation systems while maximizing your design time efficiency. You can click on the link below or go to hunterindustries.com to download your free version of the Handbook of Technical Irrigation Information. Thank you again for joining us as we focus on design with Hunter Industries.
Thank you, Bryce.